That's right. And now there'll be a large snake, which you'll pick up behind the head. Behind the head. Quickly. Quickly. Let go. That's right. And your eyes are closing now, just sinking deeper. And as I ask you to open your eyes, you're going to be aware that there's a beaker in front of you. Do not touch the beaker. And there will be two other beakers also in front of you. You look at them. It's all right to open your eyes now. You'll see the beakers. Now I want you to focus on this beaker, because shortly I'll ask you to do something. This beaker you want to be careful of, because it is filled with acid. It is nitric acid. You've had chemistry, haven't you? And you know that the nitric acid dissolves copper. I'm going to put a penny into the acid. Look what happens. Now I want you to reach in with your hand and pick up the penny out of the acid and put it into this beaker. Take it very quickly. Go ahead. Put it in there. That's right. First, put your whole hand and close your eyes. Nothing else at all. Nothing else at all. Only my voice. Nothing else at all. That's right. That's right. All right. Now I want you to put your hand in this beaker. That's right. Only my voice. Nothing else at all. That's right. Now when you open your eyes, you're going to be aware that the beaker is still there in front of you. But beside you, you'll be aware that there's a man who's been responsible for all of the nuisance today, all of the discomfort. And you're going to become more and more annoyed at him as you think about that. In fact, you're going to pick up the beaker and throw the contents right at him. You're going to take the beaker and you'll feel good doing that. All right, and you'll do it quickly. Open your eyes, you'll see the beaker in front of you. Pick it up and throw it at him. Throw it at him. That's it. As you saw, we changed the acid for colored water while the subject's eyes were closed. The subject not only couldn't see this, but wasn't really aware of it because the smell of the acid was strong enough in the area to be quite compelling. Yet she threw the acid, what she thought was acid, at someone else. But in the same token, she picked up the rattlesnake and she was willing to take a penny out of the fuming acid. The reason why she did it, however, was not so much the fact that she was hypnotized, but the fact that she knew that I couldn't afford to have anybody be hurt, and I wouldn't want anybody to be hurt, and for that reason she trusted me. And it was the trust that mattered.
I decided that I liked Anton LaVey. He was a pleasant man. He believed in what he was doing. And underneath his somewhat Mardi Gras exterior, I sensed that there was an individual who did in fact have a new perspective on the human equation, on what humanity is.